Jorge. Good night, Jorge.
Hello. Can you
How
hear
was
me?
Acapulco?
Yes.
It was so hot.
Very hot and
Really, yeah.
Tired. No, I don't know. Say in the
Weather.
Weather is
Yeah,
very,
weather.
is very, yeah.
Very hot.
Yeah, very hot.
Yeah, I haven't
I'm
heard
sorry.
that.
Yesterday, I know have a time for the connecting.
I couldn't be in class. Excuse me. I couldn't be in class. No pude estar en clases. That's a way to say. I couldn't be in class.
Okay, thank you for correction.
No, I'm worried.
Today I see the information saying us in the WhatsApp group.
Ah, okay. Yeah. I don't know. Let me see. Ah, yeah, the information that I sent, yeah. Yeah, because some of you, well, no, maybe, you know, but some of you,
exercise.
They haven't completed the exercises.
Okay. Okay,
Jennifer,
perfect.
Welcome. Good night, Jennifer.
Good evening, teacher.
Good
How
evening.
Are you?
Fine. What about you?
So.
Really? Okay.
Really?
Oh my God. Oh wow. So, Carlos Eduardo Melgar Rivas. Good evening. Good night. Let me see if we are online. We are the champion. No, we are online. Claribel!
Hello, teacher. Good evening.
So just waiting for a minute. Okay. Three past eight. Oh my God, Joanna. Is that a picture? I know that today is Friday, Joanna. Okay. Let's go and see the attendance list. The attendance, okay.
Qué envidia, Joanna.
Who is that? Who says that? Come on. Hey, come on, guys. Don't be bad influence. See, Joanna. Amilcar Cañengues Aceituno.
Present, teacher.
Very good. Ángela Alejandra Rodríguez Astorga. Carlos Ademir Bolaños Mendoza.
¿Cómo están? Bien.
Lo siento,
aquí pasa igual,
porque
también la ley
hispana. Oh my God. Carlos Eduardo Melgar Rivas.
Present, teacher.
Kaylee Lisette Asensio de Sarmiento.
Present.
Very good. Francisca Yanira Arevalo. So let me do something. Okay. Uh-huh. Oh my God. Let's see. Sorry. Jennifer Noemí Mata Aragón.
Present.
Jorge Elvir Miranda Ramos.
Present.
José Naún Palacios Enríquez. Margot Fernández Salinas. María Emelina Iraeta de Salinas. Naúm Hernández Asensio. Nuria Elizabeth Nerio Vargas. Oscar Armando Esquivel Quiñones. Ruth Joana Alvarado Gaitán.
Present, teacher.
Almost sleeping, no. Raúl Adolfo Beltrán. Vanessa Odette Guardado Enríquez. Silvana Beatriz Martínez Martínez.
Present, teacher.
Ok. Yancy Guadalupe Erazo García. Soy la Claribel Rosales.
Present, teacher.
Very good. Are you sick?
Yes, teacher. I'm sick.
Look, you sound. Maritza Alcira Castellón. You sound sick. Hugo Alexander Castro. Oh, Nuria, you are here, Nuria. Nuria Elizabeth Nerio Vargas.
Present, teacher.
Very good. Okay, I think so that you are all for today. And today is Friday. I don't know how did they react because Friday is always one of the heavy day, maybe. Friday and Monday are the heavy day. Okay. So today we have to go, we have to remember a little bit about the industry vocabulary, but we have to remember about the simple or the present using W questions and do and does. I was watching yesterday that some of you have problems. Okay, to start the class, we are gonna start making a WH questions using do and does, okay? Maybe we can use do, that is the most common, but also we can use does. But we have to start doing that kind of questions. Voy a empezar yo para demostrar, por ejemplo. Joanna, because you are the first on my screen, you know, that is, you have to blame to Zoom. Okay, Joanna? You have to open your mic, sorry. Joanna.
Uh-huh.
Oh. Who do you work with, Joanna?
¿Mi trabajo qué?
¿Con quién trabaja? Who do you work with?
Como compañero de trabajo, ¿qué algo pues así? Sí.
Ajá. I work with, por ejemplo, no sé, yo trabajo con.
I work with what's the meaning of conserje?
Janitor. What's the meaning? No, how do you say conserje
how do you
in
say
Spanish, how in do English?
You say,
sorry.
How do you say? How do you say?
How conserje. Do you say?
How do you say conserje?
In English. Conserje in English, obviously, no? Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
Janitor.
Janitor.
Janitor. That is the janitor. Okay, you work with the janitor.
Yes.
Ah, okay. Now, okay. But you don't have the bus too much there. That's a good point.
Bus.
Ah, you are the boss of the janitor. Okay, that's okay.
Teacher,
hi.
Can you type, please?
Janitor. Yes, of course. Just let me see. Janitor. That's it. Okay, Joanna, you have to ask to Jorge, and after Jorge has to ask Amilcar, come on, in that way. Pregúntele algo usando WH questions and do
hello, hello.
A Jorge. Huh?
Hello, okay. Hello.
No, pero hello. Va a ser, no, primero va a ser Joanna a Jorge. Okay. Come on, Joanna, you have to do it. You have you to open it. Your you've mic, got... Joanna.
She is a what one opportunity.
Do? What do you do, Jorge?
Bye. What do you do, Jorge?
The question is,
what do you do?
What do you? This moment I lost.
You are lost.
Sí.
Recuer que le quiso decir, Joanna? Hoy le doy permiso de que lo traduzca, so you can translate it.
¿A qué te dedicas?
Sí, eso, Bárbara, Joanna, very good.
Okay, so sorry.
Don't worry.
I work in the system administrator.
I am. Pero usted qué es? ¿Esa es como tu ocupación o tu trabajo?
Yes, my work.
Entonces, you say I am a,
System administrator.
I am an administrator assistant.
Assistant.
Or administrative. Administrative. Uh-huh. Asistente administrativo, no?
Yes. Yes.
Administrative assistant.
Assistant. Yes.
Es que ya les dije, tienen que entender que en el inglés no es como el español. Como yes. He explicado, the hot milk es la leche caliente, porque en inglés el adjetivo que modifica al noun va primero. Por eso es que ahí está el meme, que para hablar en inglés hay que hablar al revés. Por lo menos en algunas partes es cierto. Okay.
Okay, perfect. Thank you.
Okay.
And Amilcar.
Okay, you have to ask to Amilcar. Thank you, Joanna. Ajá, ask to Amilcar. No sé, una pregunta que tenga. WH y do.
Really, really? I lost the
WH questions.
The tema.
El WH questions.
Yes.
WH question. Okay, you have forgotten.
Yes, I know assistant today in the class.
No, pero eso es para hoy. Vamos a ver. Last okay. WH question. What, where, who, why? And by example, what, where, who, why, who, where, and where, when, those are WH questions. The most common.
For example, Amilcar, who do you work with?
Vaya, ¿con quién trabaja, Amilcar? Who do you work with?
I work in two men and four women.
Okay, I work with Amilcar. No,
I work with for two men and four women.
I work with two men and four women, no?
Yes.
Ah, okay. Now, Amilcar, to Silvana.
Silvana.
Hi, teacher.
Hi, darling. Oh, my God. She's very happy.
What do you do in the work?
What do you do in your work? Perfect.
Work.
Yeah.
Okay. I arrive at my work or my office at 8 a.m. and I check my email and I send the to prepare the computer and my principal
responsibility.
Okay. Exactly. And my responsibility is I retain the credit cards and I receive the.
¿Qué es retain?
Retain, retener.
Retain
the credit cards and for each call, I send the report and I show the. ¿Cómo se le dice indicadores, teacher? How do you say indicadores?
Achievements.
Achievement.
Okay.
In my work, the indicator say KPI.
KPA. Lo que es KPA.
I see the indicadores en el. In my work,
habría que ver. I mean, you have to see what this acronym means. But indicador is achievement. I mean, achievement is indicador. Achievement, eso sí, es logro, indicador. Ajá, es logro.
It depends about the work, the talk, teacher.
¿Ah?
Y eso depende de qué. ¿De qué indicador de qué? Porque pueden haber muchos indicadores de muchas cosas.
Uh-huh. Okay.
Perfect. That's why.
Okay.
Porque también algunas veces es indicator. Uh-huh. Indicator.
Yes.
Okay. I know. Okay. Now, Silvana, to Carlos. I'm going to take time again.
Okay.
To Carlos Melgar.
Okay.
What?
Carlos, what do you do on weekend?
Okay.
I work the weekend. I get up the 7 o'clock. I travel the my home of the company. I visit my mother. Bueno, encerrarme básicamente porque no puedo hacer muchas cosas, solo salir de la casa y al trabajo. Lo siento, compañera.
Ok, Carlos, I work at weekends. O sea, si dice o
I work
trabajo.
At weekend.
Ajá, weekends o trabajo. Ajá, o I work on Saturday. Yo trabajo el sábado. Y I get up at.
Ok.
Exacto.
Thanks, teacher.
Carlos, Maritza.
Okay, Maritza, what is do you do position in the company?
What is your position in the company? Uh-huh.
Good evening. my position is manager assistant.
Manager assistant, very good. Thank you. Maritza Tuburia.
Nuria.
Hello.
Cualquier pregunta, teacher.
Sí, solo que tiene que usar las WH questions y el do y el das, he dicho, para que vayamos familiarizándonos con esto.
Ok, Nuria, where do you work?
Más calmo. Very good.
Where do you work? ¿Dónde está mi trabajo? No, no le...
¿Dónde
trabajas? ¿Dónde trabajas?
I work in Banco Promérica.
Excellent. Most common question. Thank you. Nuria to Claribel Rosales. Thank you, Maritza.
Okay.
Hello, Claribel.
Hello, Nuria.
Hello.
She's almost dying. Be careful.
What do you do at work, Claribel?
Okay.
What do you do, qué, perdón?
At work. ¿Qué haces en el trabajo? What do you do at work?
I am
at work.
Okay. I am executive VIP. I give credits. I give credit card.
Stop ahí, just two. No más, por favor. Please, okay. Claribel. Thank you.
Sorry.
Voy a omitir que Claribel pregunte porque sí la oigo bien mal, Claribel.
Ya tengo mi pregunta, teacher.
¿Quiere preguntar? Que... Vaya, pues.
Yes, yes.
En un momento pensé que Claribel iba a decir, yo soy tu padre.
En El Salvador, you say, yo soy tu tata. En El Salvador. Clary Rosales. Jennifer
Noemi. Okay. Jennifer, what do you have for dinner?
Okay. Jennifer. I mean.
Nothing.
Nothing. Thank you, Jennifer, for your participation.
Haven't had dinner yet.
I already have dinner. That's okay. Very good. I already have dinner. Yo ya cené. I already have dinner.
Okay.
Very good. Thank you. Jennifer, to Daily.
Paola, what is your day off?
What is your?
Day off?
Yeah, what is your day off, Daily? Daily?
No escuché, es que está algo mal el internet.
What is your day off? ¿Cuál es su día libre? What is your day off?
My day is Sunday.
Okay, my day off is Sunday. Very good. Daily to Carlos.
Day off or day free is the similar or equal, teacher?
I mean, they are the same. O sea, lo que pasa es que para generalmente para referirse al trabajo es day off.
As to action.
What?
Como de acción, ¿verdad? De estar accionado.
No, es decir, para lo que pasa es que día libre, ¿cómo le digo? Generalmente se entiende que puede ser, es igual, pero ¿cómo le digo? Digamos que está, no sé. No, ya voy a buscarle, pero generalmente la expresión más común para cuando me refiero a trabajo es day off.
Ok.
Ajá. Daily.
Do you like to dance?
Carlos Ademir Bolaños.
Evening. Yes, I do.
Okay, very good. Veamos, Carlos Bolaños, tú, Vanessa Odette.
Vanessa, what you like to do in your free time?
What do you like?
I like Sunday. Free like.
I like what?
Sunday free like.
No, what do you like to do on your free day? ¿Qué le gusta hacer en su día? O sea, ¿qué le gusta hacer en su tiempo libre? Free time, sorry, free time.
Okay. I like I like movies. How do you
I
say
like
that?
To watch movies.
So I like to watch movies.
Uh-huh.
I go to the beach.
I go to the beach, very good.
I like eat pupusas.
Okay. Okay. Thank you. Odette, to Alejandra Ostorga.
Hey, Alejandra, what?
What? Maybe he's having problem with the internet. Yes. Well, Amilcar.
Yes, teacher.
Yes, I was watching in a forum and say, I mean, in a context, we definitely go with day off or take a day off or take a day off is the usual way to say it, okay? If you want to say a free day, it's in the sense of having nothing in particular to do. O sea, que decir un día libre es cuando no tengo nada particular que hacer. ¿Me entiende? O sea, día libre, perdón, day off es la expresión más común. Aunque
refiriéndonos a cesar de actividades.
Es como no ir al trabajo, pues por eso es un day off, es como que el día que le toca de descanso el trabajo. Pero digamos que en su casa la señora le dice que tiene que hacer esto, que tiene que hacer lo otro, ya no se volvió su día libre, sino que es el día que no va al trabajo, pero sí tiene que hacer cosas en la casa.
Sí, le pone actividades.
Digamos que el free day sería que no tenga nada que hacer, ¿ok? Do you understand?
I want to cry, teacher.
Okay. Yes. Just to give an explanation.
Understand very well.
Just to give an explanation. Hey, I am married, okay? I know about that.
Yes.
I'm married. I know about that. And I think that everybody who is married know about that, okay?
Yeah. Okay. It's terrible.
Come on, guys. Okay, let's gonna see our conversation, okay? The conversation for today is here in our manual. Let me share my screen. Yeah, it's here. Okay, let me see. It's here. Okay, listen to your teacher, the conversation. Okay. Hello, good morning. Are you Mr. Young? Yes, I am. I am Miss Tate. I am the trainer. Nice to meet you. Hello, nice to meet you too, Miss Tate. Let me introduce the staff. This is Mario. He is the branch manager and this is Leo. Welcome, nice to meet you. Nice meeting you, Mario. Nice to meet you. Leo, what do you do?
Thank you.
Nice to meet you. I am in charge of the kitchen staff. Great. Oh, Mr. Young, what does he, what does the girl over there do? She is Nisa. She is in charge of purchases. Okay. Purchases. Look at here, guys. You use personnel with plural verbs. All personnel are trained to provide first aid. Okay, personnel, plural verbs. Plural verbs. Personnel are a staff followed by a singular or plural verb. The staff work 40 hours a week. Our kitchen staff follow or follows. ¿Cómo lo sé? Si solo es staff, puede ser parte, puede ser uno, o staff puede ser más de uno. Personal es siempre varios y se usa con el plural de los verbos, ¿ok? Esa es la diferencia. Por eso ustedes pueden ver acá que este tiene sin la S, dice, o con la S. Este sin la S y este con la S, ¿ok? That's the, I mean, the way to use it. Ajá. Okay, let's gonna complete the exercises, okay? Let's gonna complete these exercises. What, ¿cómo diría aquí? ¿Qué tiene que llevar?
Hello.
Uh-huh. The auxiliary.
The auxiliary, ¿cuál auxiliar? Perfecto.
Tú.
Das.
Oh, das, perfecto. Los que estuvieron conmigo, vaya, no me dejen así. What does Mario?
Do.
Do. Exacto. What does Mario do? Okay. And what does Mario do?
Mario.
Mario. Ah, Mario is in charge of.
Manager's branch.
Mario, what do you do? Nice to meet you. I am in charge of the kitchen. Hello, Miss. No, 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 Mrs. Diana, trainer. Hello. Yeah. Mario is in charge of the kitchen staff. Okay. According to this dialogue. Siguiente. What?
Do.
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 Do. You.
You
do.
You do.
Do, Leo. What do you do, Leo? Exactly. So, no, but Leo is the, in charge of the kitchen staff, no? Nice to meet you, Mario. Nice yes. to meet you. No, no.
Mario,
Leo.
Mario is manager branch or branch manager.
Branch manager. It's Mario Young. Because Mr. Young is the manager. Well, when, okay, let's gonna complete this and I'm gonna give it to you the answer, okay? Because I have here.
Okay.
And the other one is what? Uh-huh.
Does.
What does
Mario do?
What does
Mario do?
No, en la última, number three, Amilcar.
Number three.
What does Nisa do?
What does Nisa do? Exactly. What does Nisa do? That's it. Okay. So let me check the answer then.
She is a trade of purchase.
Ah, yeah. She is. And that's it. Just the discussion is about Mario, no? Okay.
Yes.
About Mario. What does Mario do? This is page 21, exercise 3. Unit 1, unit 2, page
branch 21.
Ah, yeah, he's the branch manager. Yes, Amilcar, very good. Mario is Mr. Young, and he's the branch manager. Very good. I was committing a mistake. Okay, questions here. Remember, let me show you something. Okay, let me show you this. Okay, this. Okay, vocabulary, industry. These are the these are the WH question, guys. This is just a remember. WH question. Who, where, when, why, what, y otras que existen como what time, how, how often, how old, y otras como how many, how much, son las WH questions. Casi siempre se usan con, si son preguntas directas, por ejemplo, voy a explicar rápido. Una pregunta sin lógica sería, ¿usted vive? Claro, si está hablando, es porque vivo. Pero ya la pregunta lógica es, ¿where do you live? ¿Ah? ¿Where do you live? Acá, por ejemplo, tengo esta. ¿Do you need? No tiene sentido, solo do you need. Entonces, you say, ¿what do you need? ¿Ok? This is a review. Why? Because we are watching in the dialogue. What do you do? What do you do is equal to this. Let me check. Borrar los dibujos. No tenemos. What do you do means an occupation. I am plus occupation. What do you do? Ah, I am a doctor, I am a businesswoman, I am a businessman, I am a teacher, I am an assistant, I am whatever. What do you do? It always refers to the occupation, okay? And after you say, where do you work? The place to work, okay? Ah, I work at, look at here, I work at a hospital, I work at a school, I work blah, blah, blah. Or you can say, I work for the government or for a person. I work for the mayor or I work for a company, for a private company. I work, this is the way to say. This is just a review. Amilcar, something to ask Amilcar always. No.
Something.
Algo que preguntar, something to ask.
Yes, mayor, what is? What do you mean?
Mayor, an official who is elected to be the head of the government of a city or town. Alcalde. In Spanish word, mayor is el alcalde. Mayor. Okay. Que aquí podría también. Sí, mayor. That is the mayor. Okay.
Gobernador is government.
Depende. Governor, I mean, depende. Senator, lo que pasa es que hay algunos que son más locales y hay palabras, pero governor, I mean, es como eso, gobernador. Lo que pasa es que esa palabra...
¿Diputado?
Es senator.
Senator.
Ajá, solo, senator, sí. Solo déjeme ver, just let me see la pronunciación, porque sí sé que se escribe senator, pero creo que se pronuncia, oh no, my God, just let me check the pronunciation, because, aquí, okay. Senador, yeah,
Senador.
That's it, senator. Okay. Any other question, guys? Remember, some of you did questions, but you have to remember that the questions have to be do. They have to use do because are the main point when you make a direct questions, okay? When you are making a direct question, you have to use do. What do you do? Where do you live? Who do you love? Por ejemplo, ¿a quién amas? Who do you love? ¿A quién amas? Lo mismo en su trabajo. Por ejemplo, what do you do? Okay. Como dijimos que eso es más mi ocupación. Por ejemplo, yo soy asistente legal. Ok, what do you do there? ¿Qué haces ahí? Ah, I have to, blah, blah, blah. I have to prepare reports. I have to review the lawsuit. Por ejemplo, quiero ver, ¿dónde está? No, se nos fue otra vez. No pude estar, ¿cómo no? Quiero ver, no la veo, no veo a Margot. Dijo que estaba cayendo en Berlín. Ni a Yanira. solo a manera, you don't have to be, pero ya sacaron el proyecto de ley de las reformas constitucionales. Solo pude leer 5 artículos ahorita. Pero you have to take into account. But the point is, I mean, but the point is that this is the way to ask, okay? What do you do? Where do you live? Something like that, okay? Follow up. We'll leave exercise. This review. Okay, question here, guys. Question here. Preguntas hasta aquí. Teacher, I am at work. I have problem inside the production floor and I will have to get up from. Okay. Okay. Ale, I got it. Please, after you can come in, I will appreciate it, okay? So, question here with this topic. Do you remember this topic? Este tema es del módulo 2.
Yes, teacher.
Hi.
For example, in the sentences, it's a mistake to unit to verb.
To join. In this case, it's to join.
Join, okay. And then the second for verb is ing.
No. That's another topic. I mean, that's another topic. Ese es otro tema, Amilcar. Pero
se lo comento porque, teacher, se lo comento porque de repente aparece ese conflicto a la hora de generar una pregunta o formular una oración. A veces uno, pues sí, con el error que uno traduce. A veces uno une dos acciones que involucran dos verbos.
Lo que pasa es de que usted a veces puede que traduzca como verbos. The point is that you translate as a verb. Pero usted tiene dos verbos. Muchas veces uno es verbo y el otro puede ser un noun. Esa es la diferencia. Que a veces, por ejemplo,
pero la expresión to hace que uno cambie de forma con relación al primero, por ejemplo.
Depende de la oración. Por ejemplo, le voy a poner una oración simple. I have to record the record.
Record.
Ajá, record record. Exacto. Yo tengo que grabar la grabación. Uno es noun y otro es verbo.
Yes, yes, yes.
Entonces,
pero siempre hay una partícula que los divide. Da o to, for, by.
No siempre. En la mayoría de los casos sí, pero no siempre.
No se lo pregunto porque me quiera adelantar, sino
no,
tranquilo. Se lo pregunto porque de repente entro en conflicto y me encasquillo allí y no hay cómo salir del atolladero.
Lo que pasa es que usted, sí, bueno, si me lo permite, sí tiene eso de decir bastante el tú. El tú solo se usa generalmente en algunos verbos cuando yo digo I like to o cuando digo I have to. Pero cuando el verbo va solo con el pronoun, yo solo uso el verbo. Por ejemplo, I read a book, I play the guitar, that's it. Por lo menos para contestar un poco su pregunta.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, you're welcome. Okay, you have to grammar. Okay. Question with this topic, guys. Oh my God. Question with this topic, this is just a review. Okay, solo es un review because you have watch this topic before, okay? Follow up with live group exercises. I don't know who's provided phone. I commit a mistake maybe when I saw this. Okay. If you have any problem, I will show you again just to watch. Look at here the grammar of this, that this is WH question first, After you have the auxiliary verb, after you, do you have the subject, and after do you have the complement, okay? That's the order, the grammar structure of these sentences, okay? When you say, where do you live? Where do you work? Where do you go? Where, and the same, I can change do, por ejemplo, el you, por ejemplo, si yo quiero hacerlo en tercera persona. Si yo lo quiero hacer en tercera persona, ¿qué tendría que escribir?
Does. He, he, he.
Does. Does. Primero es does. Where does, sorry by the, for the letters, where does he live, por ejemplo. Okay. ¿Dónde él vive? Lo mismo, si quiero preguntar dónde trabaja.
Where does he work?
Si quiero preguntar dónde va.
Where does he go?
O como le pregunta usted a la persona que está ahí en su hogar, ¿a dónde vas? ¿Cómo lo preguntaría?
Where do you go?
Pero así con authority. Where do you go? ¿A dónde vas? Okay. That's it. Okay. That's the structure. Okay. Esa va a ser la estructura. Okay. Acá, cuando usted está lámina en otro tiempo, aquí ya puedo hacerlo en pasado, pero por ejemplo, podría ser en presente. No se metan con esto, por favor, porque nos vamos a meter en camisa de 11 bars. Okay. What time? Ah, well, pero aquí es, does he call? ¿Qué estoy preguntando aquí? What time does he call?
¿A qué horas me vas a llamar?
Pasado.
¿A qué horas llamó?
¿A qué horas le vas a llamar?
Sí, pero olvidemos el pasado, por lo menos olvidemos el pasado. ¿A qué horas llamas? Sería en presente. ¿A qué horas llamas? ¿A qué horas llamas? Aunque es más otro tipo de estructura. Pero entienden el punto, igual how often es una bien común, tienen el punto how often, ¿ah? Luego va el do o el does. Luego va el subject. And after you have the complement. How often do you eat? ¿Cuán a menudo come? 3 times a day, 4 times a day, every hour.
Six times a day,
every minute. I don't know, I mean, but the point is, that the structure of. Okay. Do you have any question here, guys? Today is the time to make questions, okay?
I remember, teacher, when to use the auxiliaries, the verb be, don't write S, the finally verbs in the,
yeah. You don't have to write down the third person verb. I mean the S, yeah, of the verb. That's it.
Yeah.
Okay. Any other question, guys?
No question, teacher.
No questions. Okay. As we don't have questions, we are gonna take the model again. Listen to me. We are gonna take the model of the conversation that we have on our manual, and we are going to create with our company or with our words, okay? You have to work in pairs. You have to create, I mean, you have to be, I don't know, you have to present the member of your staff. Tiene que presentar. ¿Cuál es el punto? Imagínese que va a una capacitación. Y usted es el jefe, que va a una, así como se recuerda que hicimos la compañía y usted era el jefe de un departamento. I mean, now that you are the boss of a department, y tiene su staff, tiene dos. Él es mi asistente, él es el conserje, qué sé yo. Y van a una capacitación de atención al cliente, qué sé yo, de cómo incrementar sus ventas, de la visión. I don't know what kind of training are you going. No, o sea, qué clase de training are you going. A qué clase de capacitación usted va. Okay. O puede decir que va a la venta de un producto cuando lo están presentando. ¿Ah? Y eso va a ser, va a presentar a los miembros de su staff, va a decir qué es lo que hacen y va a decir y eso, y va a ir haciendo preguntas. O sea, eso. Vamos a in pairs. Vamos a trabajar en grupos de tres. Pero creo que uno creo que va a quedar de dos. Let me see. Oh my God.
Teacher.
Hi.
A mí me deja el grupo de tres para no dejar solita a la persona que le toque conmigo.
Va, perfecto. Sí, es cierto, Clary. ¿Por qué?
Gracias.
Thank Clary. No, pobrecita Clary. Tiene que tener cuidado, Clary. Good.
Sí, yes, teacher. Thank you.
I am so well, let me see that. Okay, what I did. Okay, now we go. We are five, maybe. Uh-huh, let me see. Two. Uh-huh. Yeah, it's one is gonna be of one of two. Uno va a quedar de dos. Bueno, vamos. Page 21 está en la página 21. Let me see. Let me see page 21. Yeah. The conversation is in page 21, pero si usted quiere, yo le comparto pantalla y le toma captura. Ahí está, okay. And you can get into the breakout room. Please go to the breakout rooms. ¿Quién ha entrado? Huh?
What kind of event we work?
What kind of
event?
What kind of event? Yeah.
Event.
Okay. Aquí hay de diferentes, así es que you have to decide.
Okay, okay.
Tenemos que
medio entendió que
leer el diálogo.
Que tenemos que ir a la página 21 de nuestro manual, ¿sí? Tomar como modelo, crear un evento y presentar ahí y presentar, digamos usted es el jefe. Mire, ella es fulana, ella es mengana. Ah, ¿y qué ella hace? O sea, todo eso. Usted puede hacer si quiere más de dos partes. Puede hacer el jefe, qué sé yo, y el capacitador. I don't know, I mean, that's the point. Pero tienen que crear una conversación modelo de ese en ese sentido.
No, okay, okay. Sí, lo siento.
Good night, good evening.
Good evening, Jennifer. Nice to see you. What do you need, repeat, Jennifer?
Repeat, sorry?
What do you need?
Repeat the instructions.
Instructions or the indications, okay? Whatever.
Instructions.
Okay. The instructions. Okay, you have to go to the page, to page 21, sorry, in your manual, and there you are gonna find, or even if you want, I can share the conversation, that is this, okay? And you have to take this conversation as a model to create your own conversation, okay? You have to create the event and do the conversation. You have to present the member of your staff, okay? That's it.
Using the WH question, right?
Yes, but I mean, you can take the model of this conversation that they are, I mean, what do you do? What does the girl over there do? I mean, you can use the model. If you want to include any other WH question, you can include. But the first thing is that you have to take the model of this conversation.
Only replace with my information.
Yeah.
In daily information.
Yeah. I mean, but not with your information. Maybe it's that you have to create an event. Como dije, tiene que, como que va a una capacitación y, o algún seminario, que es lo que pasa acá. Acá, este, Mr. Young está yendo a un seminario.
Es que como somos dos y como hay como cuatro participantes en...
Pero eso en no la... importa. Mejor para ustedes, hacen otras voces. Better for you. O sea, okay. Aprovechar porque van a poder hablar más inglés, I mean.
Perfecto.
Okay.
Thank you, teacher.
You're welcome. Y en la sala 3 no ha entrado nadie. Mike. Nuria y Alvarado están, no han entrado. Number three, there are no worries.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, that's it. Eso es.
Okay.
Entonces sería, hello, good night. Are you Mr. Carlos?
Mr. Bolaños. El Mr. se usa con los nombres. Are you Mr. Bolaños?
Eso necesito saber. La diferencia de Miss es que yo no me acuerdo si recibí esa clase.
Miss es para Miss Martínez y Mr. es para Mr. Bolaños. Y en el caso,
chico.
Y si está casada es Mrs.
Miss
es M-S, es para
una dama.
Mm.
Mrs. es para una señora, si así lo quiere ver.
Ah,
y Mister es para señor o para señorito, como quiera.
Pero como usted dijo, no se refirió a apellido o nombre.
Ah, por eso. Es que por eso. No, me refiero a que es apellido. O sea, por ejemplo, a Mr. Bolaños, por ejemplo. ¿Ah? Mr. Bolaños. ¿Ah?
Y no, solo dijera el nombre.
Ah, lo que pasa es que puedo decir I am Carlos, pero si yo digo I am Mr., yo tengo que decir ya mi apellido. I am Carlos o I am Mr. Najarro.
Ok.
Pero es que yo tengo la duda, o sea, Mr. John es apellido.
Sí.
Apellido.
Ah, yo creía que era
Mr. John es apellido.
Yo creía que era nombre chino. Por ahí así de asiático.
No, Mr. John es apellido.
Ah, cuando uno dice Mr.
Entonces tenemos apellido.
Sí, pero también a veces puede decir nombre, eso es irrelevante. Lo relevante es por lo menos hacer la conversación. Ahora vuelven acá. Aún yo me confundí, pero Mr. Young es, en realidad es Mario Young.
Ah.
Mario, nice to meet you.
Sí. Y Miss Tate es la capacitadora. Nuria and Joanna, what happened to you, girls?
Teacher, me dio problema el internet y me sacó de la reunión. Tuve que volver a ingresar.
Ah, bueno. I was watching what happened to Joanna and Nuria because I came into this breakout room and I was alone. Vine a esta sala y estaba solo. That's why.
Sí, es que se ve. El internet me está fallando.
Don't worry.
Okay. La página 21 dijo, ¿verdad?
Exacto, 21. Ahí está el diálogo. Okay. Va a ser un modelo, ese diálogo, pero reemplazando la información que usted le ponga. En realidad, el diálogo is about a training. Es como de una capacitación o una venta de producto. Y si solo son dos, pues solo ustedes dos van a hacer, pueden hacer diferentes roles. El punto is to speak English, ¿ok?
Ok.
Ah, ya lo vamos.
Lo que pasa es, no, pero ya lo voy a mandar, es solo para pasar lista. Ya está como que no quiere hablar y no quiere hacer las cosas. Ay, Johanna. Ay, es solo para pasar lista, Johanna. Ay, Johanna. Como si no conociera yo a mi pueblo.
Ay, voy a traer la libreta, pues, para anotar.
Oh, my God.
Mira que tengo un sueño, teacher, increíble.
Así la he visto, Johanna. I know that it's very tiring. Pero I appreciate your effort, okay? Después la vamos a mandar de misionera.
Me veo terrible. Uy, sí.
Ay, no. Ve eso que no le preocupe. Más vale el aprendizaje que la belleza. La belleza se acaba, el aprendizaje no.
Esto sale, esto queda en YouTube.
That's why.
Ah, ok.
It is just for the attendance. Solo para pasar lista. Después regresamos, okay?
Ah, okay.
It was because I need to go with the attendance.
Okay.
That's why. No, it's not because we haven't finished. Okay.
Okay.
Angela Ostorga. Carlos Ademir Bolaños Mendoza.
Presente, teacher.
Very good. Francisca Yanira Arevalo Rodríguez. Senaún Palacios Enríquez. Margot Hernández Salinas. Emelina Iraeta de Salinas. Raúl Hernández Asensio. Oscar Armando Esquivel Quiñones.
Present.
Saúl Adolfo Beltán. Vanessa Odette Guardado Enríquez.
Present, teacher.
Nancy Guadalupe Erazo García. Maritza Alcira Castellón Celaya.
I'm here, teacher.
Very good. Hugo Alexander Castro.
Present, teacher.
Very good. Then, again, here we go. You can continue on the conversation, guys.
Solo invertí $50. No vayas a meter más en la compra.
Come on.
No más. Ya se oyó, hombre. No worry. Lo tenía activado. Por eso lo desactivé.
Ah, sorry.
Nosotros con un producción del puesto que tenemos, de dónde le visitamos,
que queremos ser,
ajá, y de ahí continuamos con la de las preguntas a Milcar, yo le pregunto a Milcar, usted me pregunta a mí y seguimos la secuencia.
Very good. Try to speak in English, but very good. I'm here, okay.
Ah, teacher. Ya.
Estamos refiriendo a estar lejos, ¿verdad?
Sí, far es que away. Por eso le...
Ah, yeah, far away.
Ah, and the other four, forma, four.
form.
For I can see the I can say the one who is there is drinking coffee is John. Como el que está al fondo, pero si lo vemos del punto que me dice Castellón podría ser de esa manera, solo dejar a this Leo is there in drinking coffee.
O también pueden tomar otros roles, no pueden limitarse solo a su rol, puede por ejemplo hacer dos el papel de Leo. Esa también podría ser una parte para poder hablar más. No limitarse al rol, solo,
No sacarlo.
Ajá.
No, sí, porque como.
Y van a hablar. Y van, sí, pero pueden hablar más. Aunque aquí están tres, Clara y Rosales está aquí.
Sí, ahí la tenemos, ahí está.
¿Sí? Ahí está guardada. Ah, ok.
Ok. Va, entonces,
Hello. Good morning. Are you Mr. Bolaños?
Yes, I am.
Neil va a decir, yes, I am Mr. Bolaños.
Very good.
Hey, nos quitó la conversación de ahí. Entonces,
the shares of purchase.
What? Purchase.
Purchase.
Compras.
Purchases.
No, purchasing.
Chairs.
Cargar.
Cargar.
Perdón.
Okay.
Chairs.
Cargar. De cargar, de cobrar. That's it.
Oh, ¿o cuál? No es cargar de.
Charge.
No, cargar de eso, no. Eso sería take.
Oh. In the diálogo, perdón, in the conversation.
Ajá.
Is chairs.
¿A dónde?
A.
Let me see. Conversation, you said. There is, let me see. Conversation, I can have it. Ah, pero ahí es encargado de. Allá, yo soy encargado de. Esa parte ya la vimos. I am in charge of. Ok, I am in charge of. Yo estoy encargado de, no es de cargar. Yo soy el cargador. Come on. I am in charge of purchasing. Yo estoy encargado de las compras.
She is in charge of.
I am in charge of purchasing. Yeah. That's it. I am in charge of purchasing. Jennifer, unfortunately, you have to stay with me today, no?
All right. What?
You have to stay with me today.
You are
the winner of the lottery for today.
I'm sorry.
You are the winner. For today, you are the winner.
Winner.
Usted es la ganadora de quedarse conmigo hoy hasta las 10:10.
Oh my God. Okay.
Okay.
Perfect.
Thank you.
Sí.
Really.
Genial.
Really.
Uh-huh. Yes. Really es.
Really así como es como es algo es así genial. Como. Genial. Pero es más que todo algo así. De verdad, really.
Ajá, vaya. Ajá, por eso le decía yo, Noria. Uh-huh.
Really.
Really? Ajá, gusta, que Nuria me está contando.
¿Te gusta ese? Y así le falta un diente y todo, y es todo pelón, y usted dice, really? Nuria, come on, Nuria. Yeah, but he doesn't have a student. It is bald. I mean, but maybe has money. It's a sugar. It's a sugar daddy.
Sugar daddy.
Ah, you see, Joanna. Joanna is very happy when mentioned sugar daddy.
Se le quitó tu sueño, Joanna.
Well, mencionaron sugar daddy.
Yeah, when she hears sugar daddy, okay, ah, oh, sugar daddy. It doesn't matter if he doesn't have teeth. No importa si no tiene dientes, okay?
No se importa, dicho.
No, because it's a sugar daddy. Sugar daddy, the important is money. Come on.
Yes. Claro,
okay,
yes.
Girls, continue working on the conversation. No ball, no hair, no teeth. I mean, no cabello, no dientes, just money.
Oh my God.
Él va a salir en las fotos.
Okay. Yeah, you can show him on Facebook. That's it. Okay, continue working on the conversation. You have to do a model, okay? Sí saben qué van a hacer, ¿verdad? No problem.
Yes, teacher.
Okay.
Okay, I work.
Sí, pero nosotros no tenemos el otro integrante, teacher. Podemos cambiar la conversación.
No, pueden hacer otro rol. Pueden tomar ustedes más roles. No tiene que tomar solo uno. Puede, por ejemplo, usted tomar otro rol para hablar más inglés, Joanna, para prosperidad suya.
No, yo no estoy diciendo para no hablar, sino cómo cambiar la conversación, porque no sabe el otro.
Cabal, pero como le digo, pero en lugar de cambiar la conversación, que le va a ser más difícil, lo mejor es que tome el lugar de él y que usted haga los dos papeles. Algo así como en una obra cuando no hay actores.
Vaya, pues.
You cannot win, okay? Today is Friday, Joanna. We have to be happy.
Mañana y el domingo todavía voy a trabajar. Oh my God.
But you love your work, Joanna. Pero usted ama su trabajo.
Yeah.
Okay, that's why.
Exactly.
Again, in Spanish, come on.
Okay.
When I come in here, you are speaking in Spanish, Carlos. Come on.
This is Spanglish.
Ah, Spanglish. Where
do you work, okay, Vanessa?
Continue, please.
Okay. So sorry, Mr. Cañengues. I'm leaving.
I'm manager in this John.
Clary.
Welcome. Nice to meet you.
Nice meeting you, Mr. Miranda. No. Nice meeting you, Clary. Nice to meet you, John. What do you do?
Nice to meet you. I am church of the kitchen staff.
Great, Mr. Miranda. What does the girl over there do?
What happened?
Okay, ¿en cuál vamos?
In the four. May introduce the staff.
Seguí hablando, no tenga pena.
Staff. Pucha, esta es como la raqueta que yo tengo. Pro staff.
Estaba full English y de repente te callaste.
Entonces, de repente vas a decir tú, this is Oscar. He is the branch manager.
Se nos fue al baño, Hugo, teacher.
Aunque no haya dejado activada la cámara ni los sonidos suficientes.
No, yo le dije que todo le salga bien, le dije, yo ya vi.
My God.
Okay, Ivo. ¿Lo vamos a practicar en general?
Yes. Daily is here.
In general.
Okay, es el. Okay.
Okay, okay. Yes, 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 yes.
Outlet.
Okay, so.
Outlet.
Well,
which is outlet or outlook? What is this?
Amilcar.
Let me see.
The question, where do you to locate? No, sería where do you locate?
Tampoco.
Ajá.
Tampoco.
Sí, teacher. Where do you locate?
No.
How do you say?
Es where are you? En ese caso es where are you? O where is the company located?
Ajá. Es...
Where are?
I mean,
¿dónde están ubicados?
Exacto, ¿dónde están ubicados? Located es ubicados y where are you located? ¿Dónde estás tú ubicado? Where are they located? ¿Dónde están ellos ubicados? Ok.
Located.
Located. Entonces sería where are you located o where are you do?
No. Where are you located?
Ok, where are, así lo tenemos, a ver si estamos bien, teacher.
Ok.
Thanks. Vanessa, ¿cuál sería la dirección entonces?
Oh my God. Ajá, y esa pregunta, ¿cómo es?
Where are you located?
What is the address?
Exactly.
The address, correcto. What is the address?
What is the address? It's in Paseo.
The company.
Address, sorry.
What?
Oh, Paseo.
Paseo General Escalón.
Paseo General Escalón.
Ya, yeah. Los nombres propios no se traducen.
Sí, correcto, así es.
O sea, Paseo General Escalón, aquí en la China, Paseo General Escalón.
Entonces, aterrizando, where are company locator?
Ah, va, pero si es company, ¿cuántos son? Exactly.
Where is company located?
Where is the company located?
The company. The company. Ahí dudé por el da company.
No, pero cuando ya está hablando de la compañía, porque es, ya sabe qué es la compañía, qué compañía se está refiriendo. Where is the company located?
Okay.
Church of the kitchen. Staff.
What up, Mr. Miranda? What does the kid over there do?
She is Maria. She...
Meeting. Mario, nice to meet you. Leo, what do you do?
Nice to meet you. I am Charles. Of the kitchen staff.
I am in charge of.
I am in charge
of.
Charge of the kitchen staff.
Exactly.
Great of Mr. Joe. What does the girl over there do?
She is Nisa. She is in charge.
No sé, algo así.
Pero es el como redundante. Es el redundante.
¿El qué? What is redundant?
Que ya van dos veces que le voy a decir que soy branch manager.
Sí. No, pero lo puedes quitar de la oración de arriba.
Exacto.
No, because in the letter, in the next paragraph, what do you do is a referent. ¿Qué tú haces en el trabajo? No, ¿qué eres en el trabajo?
Ok.
Y si eso está bien. Solo que vamos a poner lo que, o sea, ¿cuál es tu, o sea, cuál es tu función?
Maybe, uh-huh. Yeah. It's good.
It's good.
Ok.
Mm-hmm.
Bring the tea.
Give up. Give up is the give up is the word. Ríndete. Give up. Give up is the word.
Mm-hmm.
Give up, never give up.
Share of, share of, share of purchases. Share of.
Okay.
Share of. Share of. Charge of.
¿Se podrá unir? Share of.
Charge.
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 No, charge. Of. Charge. I am in charge of purchases.
Charge of purchases.
I am, or oh, she is in charge of purchases.
Share of.
In charge of purchases.
Of purchases.
Purchases. Yeah.
Again, Hugo.
Okay. Hello. Good morning. Are you Jenny?
Yes, I am.
I am Mr. Hugo. I am administrative manager. Nice to meet you.
Hello. Nice to meet you, Mr. Hugo. Let me introduce the staff. This is Daily. She is a secretary, and this is Leo.
Welcome. Nice to meet you.
Nice meeting you, Daily. Nice to meet you. What do you do? Leo, what do you do?
Nice to meet you. I am charge of the office.
I am in charge of the office. And it's Daily. It's I am in charge of.
I am in charge of. Charge of.
Yes, no, it's nice. It's nice. Nice to meet you. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Exacto. Y cuando hablo, por ejemplo, de Mr., caso de Jennifer, Hugo y los demás, hablo del apellido.
Mr. Castro.
Exacto. Cuando yo digo Mr., yo digo el apellido. Ahora, si yo digo, por ejemplo, hablo de mí. Yo digo, I am Carlos, está bien. Pero si yo digo, I am Mr., tengo que decir mi apellido. I am Mr. Najarro. ¿Ok? Hugo Valdés, todo mi nombre. I am Mr. Carlos Najarro. Pero always the, por ejemplo, en el caso, she is Miss Mata. ¿Ok?
Yeah.
En el caso de Daily, creo que Daily es Daily, she is Mary, por ejemplo. Daily is Mary. ¿Ah? De Asensio, ¿verdad? Uh-huh. Entonces, vale, por ejemplo, en el caso de ella es Mrs. Asensio. Mrs. Asensio. Mrs.
Oh,
porque gosh. Está casada.
Señora. Y es como,
exacto, señora de Asensio. Mrs. Asensio. Jennifer, she is single, es Miss Mata. ¿Ok?
Okay.
Miss Mata y él es Mr. Castro. Entonces, solo para que lo tengan en cuenta, cuando hablo de es Mr. Hugo, digamos que para los ingleses es incorrecto. Digo Mr. Hugo Castro o Mr. Castro.
Nice.
Ok, guys.
Very good. Thanks, teacher.
You're welcome. Continue.
Okay. Again.
Again.
Branch manager.
Excuse me, teacher.
No. Continue.
Ok. Vanessa, please repeat.
Branch manager.
Spell me the
branch.
B-R.
I-N. C-H.
B-R. B-R.
B-R.
A.
B-R-A-N-C-H.
Branch. Yeah. B-R. B-R-A. Branch.
I pronounce branch or branch?
No, branch.
Branch.
Branch manager.
Okay, branch manager.
Branch manager.
Yes.
Teacher.
Hi.
Reconocido.
Recognize.
Thank you.
Yeah. You're welcome.
Continue, guys.
Okay.
Yo he hecho tres preguntas.
Fail. Purchases. Fail.
Purchases. Okay. Acuérdese de
purchases.
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 Yeah, purchases.
Purchases.
Purchases. Okay.
Purchases, yeah.
Again, ladies.
Hello, okay. Good morning. Are you Mr. Miranda?
Yes, I am.
Thank you. Goodbye.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, miss. Imagine, Joanna, if you speak English and you can know a sugar daddy in English, I mean an American sugar daddy.
It's a problem, teacher.
Why? Because they are very demanding and another stuff. Don't believe me, but they say that they like the Latin American women, Latin American woman. Yeah, they like.
Yeah.
Yeah.
These son Latinos.
Yeah, those are, they have the rhythm, the Latinos rhythm. Yeah. Hey, Joanna, are you still awake?
Joanna is asleep.
Yeah, Joanna is asleep. So she's making a big effort. I mean, she's like. Pero al menos le contestó, participó como dos veces en la.
Yes,
ah, se le fue el internet. Se salió y ya va a entrar otra vez, pero se salió, por eso es. Y usted diciendo que estaba dormida.
Ya está cansada, la verdad se ve cansada.
I know that this schedule is very hard. Este horario es bien cansados. Pesado. Por eso es de que al menos trato de que, aunque si no aprenden, al menos se rían. No, I mean, you have to learn, come on.
Ah, sí, hemos aprendido un poquito.
Ah, ok, very good.
Ok, uh-huh. Empecemos con el.
What? Spanglish.
What?
Spanglish. The way to say what?
A pronunciation and the partners in me, difficult, and phone or computer.
Which words? ¿Cuáles palabras?
Ve, se no, yo digo que nos cuesta, no, nosotros nos cuesta extendernos. En, por la red.
Really?
And speak English and pronunciation. And me and the partners.
It's very hard. And, yeah, I know. Maybe because you interrupt the internet, but I mean, this is these are the ways that we have now to learn. I mean, it's better than just sleep at home. And don't do anything. I mean, at least I know that everybody is tired, because I know that everybody's tired. And but you are doing a big effort. Okay, you can do your best. And I know that this way to learn, this new virtual way to learn, have advantages and disadvantages. Maybe as everything, what can we do? We can use the advantages to learn. That's it. I understand, Oscar Armando. But that we have now, and we have to use very well.
Thank you.
You're welcome, Mr. Bolaños.
Mm-hmm. Vaya niño. Entonces así pongámosle como dijimos.
Sí. Yes, ya está creado. Uh-huh.
Tú lo copiaste en tu cuaderno, ¿verdad?
Sí.
Para que no los mandes y veamos en qué orden vamos.
Ay, no sé cómo te hace.
Primero Mr. Martínez, después Mr. Carlos, después Mr. Martínez, después Mr. Carlos, después Mr.
Sí, pero ¿dónde se los mando, niño?
¿A WhatsApp?
Pues sí, los números.
They are in the group.
Todos van a leer lo que les vamos.
Volvimos.
Yes, we come back. We are in the main session. Yeah, we are in the main session. Great. It means that always we are about to finish. No, half hour is missing, maybe 27 minutes. And Jennifer, 37. Because she's going to have 10 more. Sorry. Okay. So, you see that this is the way to create a conversation. I mean, also, you can go to some places and you are going to need to start a conversation, maybe, because I don't know if you have ever traveled to the USA, and when you go to a place and you can speak the language, it's very weird. I mean, you feel like the first day of a school, no, when you don't know anybody. Even words, because in the first day of school, you imagine that everybody speak your language, but imagine that you are in the first day of a school and nobody speak your language. It's gonna be hard. That's why, you need to learn this kind. Yeah, it's very difficult. I imagine that you have had the experience, no? That's why. Let me show you something then. Wait. Oh my God. Let me see. Seven. Oh my God. What is it? Oh my God. 15. No, it's P7, yeah. Sorry. Okay, I'm here. I'm gonna share chat. Thank you. Okay, thank you, Carlos. No, it's me. I am Carlos. No, not for me. No, Vanessa.
Yes. Again, no quedó tiempo, teacher.
Don't worry, I'm just kidding. Okay, here you have a kind of conversation. It's a short conversation. always the first thing that you do when you go to a place and you don't know anybody, always the first thing that you do is, what's your name? And maybe if you are in a training, in a presentation of something, maybe you know that everybody works, so you can ask him or ask her, hey, where do you work? Okay, that's the question, okay. And after, maybe, this is, some of you, I remember that says, that's the way to ask, what do you do? What do you do? It can be a different question when you say, what do you do? Okay, what do you do? Can be a question. What do you do there? Can be another question. There can give the sentence another sense. Okay, can give to the question another sense. Cuando usted dice, ¿cuál es tu ocupación? Y diferente es cuando puede decir, ¿qué haces ahí? What do you do there? Y no, obviamente le va a decir, si a usted le preguntan, ¿qué hace allí en su trabajo? Es obvio que está trabajando, ¿verdad? O sea, when you say, what do you do there? You are referring, hi, Carlos. What do you do there? It refers to be to the functions, to the to the responsibilities you have there. When you say, what do you do there? Ah, okay, like Carlos, I have to supervise. I have to do something like that, okay? This could be another question that we can join with yesterday's topic. Do you work in the headquarters or in a branch? ¿Trabaja, por ejemplo, en la oficina central o en una área? ¿O en una sucursal? It could be another question, okay? What another word can you ask? ¿Qué otra pregunta podría preguntar? What another question can you ask? Imagine that you are in a training.
What is your position? What is your position at the company?
What is your position? Yeah. What is your position in the company? Another one.
What is your aspiration in the company?
Oh my God. What is your... You want to be the CEO, pero yes, it's an aspiration, yeah? I would like to be the CEO. The CEO.
Algún día, teacher.
Ay, Carlos, very well. Se acuerda que fui su maestro, please. Okay, another word. What's your aspiration in the company?
Why do you work there?
What? Sorry?
Why?
Why?
Do you work there?
Why do you work there? Why do you work there? Sorry, work there. ¿Por qué trabajas ahí?
The pain.
For the money.
The money.
The money. It's too personal. Es bastante personal. It's too personal, okay?
Yes, it's too personal.
Dígame, Amilcar.
How much do you earn?
Oh, my God. Vaya, yo diría esto, ve.
Yeah. Because I'm
well, that's it.
Yes, me
what
too.
Do you work? Because I'm hungry.
Another question, how do you like to work?
Teacher, but I am a teacher. I don't work for money.
Yes, I know. Yes, I know, Jennifer.
Passion.
Patient. Patient. No, Jennifer, I am a teacher also, you know?
And
I'm
beans.
Here. And well, I don't work not just for money, because maybe the money is the third or the fourth.
But no. Teacher.
I mean, don't say it. Don't say it, Jorge. Please don't
okay.
say it.
Okay.
Let's say it. Let's say it.
Yes. Say.
Okay, ask then. Okay, Jorge, tell. Okay, tell us.
Is the word for all work is the passion. Yes? And the beans.
Why you are investing money? No, I know, Jennifer, that everybody works first of all because we have needs. En buen salvadoreño porque tenemos hambre, because I'm hungry. And after that, they come the core values, integrity, honesty, patience. In our case, Jennifer, patience for education, okay? So
what motivates you?
¿Cómo se dice? Sudar la camiseta.
I don't know. I mean, sweat the shirt.
Okay. Okay.
How much do you earn? How do you work? No. How do you like? No. Maybe the question is, why do you like? Why do you like to work there. ¿Por qué te gusta trabajar ahí? Solo ahí me contrataron. No,
teacher. Sometimes I read to question, how do you like your jokes?
Ah, how do you like? No, pero generalmente, how do you see? Sí, pero I don't
know. Sí, yes, it's a topic correct, teacher.
Yeah, I know. Let me see what is the sense. Sometimes because it's the sense. How do you like to work? ¿Cómo te gusta trabajar? Podría ser. How do you like to work?
No, no, no. ¿Alguna what? Vez he leído esa pregunta? Y es, how do you like? Y no se refiere a
¿te cómo, gusta tu sino... trabajo?
Sí, ajá.
¿Qué te gusta de tu trabajo?
Ah.
No, pero entonces es, what do you like?
No, no, pero, how do you like? Pero el how es como un redundante en la acción de si me gusta, de cómo me gusta, algo así, o cuánto me gusta. Pero sí he leído en un texto pues sí, va, bastante pero diferente. Serio,
bueno, vaya, pero how se puede decir, pero how much, o tal vez, how much do you like to work? O how much do you like your work? ¿Cuánto te gusta tu trabajo? How much do you like your work? Que es diferente. How much do you like your work? ¿Ah? ¿Cuánto te gusta tu trabajo? How much do you like your work? ¿Cuánto te gusta tu trabajo? Okay. How much do you like? Puede también decirlo de otra forma. How much do you like to work? ¿Cuánto te gusta trabajar? That is different. I don't know. I mean, let me see something. How do you like job? I mean, sí, podría ser algo así como how do you like job? ¿Cómo te gustaría el trabajo? Okay. Así como cómo te gustaría un trabajo. Maybe how do you like a job? ¿Cómo te gustaría un trabajo? Something like that. Mm-hmm. ¿Cómo te gustaría un trabajo? Okay. Like the meme, okay. Have you seen the meme? Dice, busco trabajo de patrón, pero solo hay de empleado. Just smile, guys.
Uy, perdón.
No worry. A smile is healthy, okay? A smile is very healthy, guys. Okay. Any other word? Any other question?
Teacher.
Mm-hmm. Hi.
How long have you worked there?
Oh, I mean, this is another question, but yeah. How long have you been working there? Working there. How long have you been working there? Sí es la pregunta. ¿Cuánto tiempo has estado trabajando ahí?
Yes.
How long have you been working there? Okay, so guys, you have to remember that these are WH questions. Casi todas, bueno, a excepción de esta, la voy a anotar ahorita mejor acá. Esta que es yes I own, ¿no? ¿Por qué trabajas ahí? ¿Por qué le pagan más? ¿Por qué se da miedo? ¿Ah? ¿Por qué te gusta trabajar ahí? Porque solo ahí me contrataron. Metí como 10 currículums y solo ahí me contrataron. Perdón, I'm just kidding, okay? But the point is that all of these are WH questions, okay? That you can do. De verdad, aunque we are making jokes, aunque estamos haciendo un poquito de chiste, recuérdense que algunas de ellas, aquí porque estamos en clases, pero la verdad es que algunas de ellas, por lo menos en nuestro país, es impropio preguntar, pues, por ejemplo, ¿cuánto ganas? La gente casi siempre es reluctant, ¿ok? Va a ser un tanto reluctant a decir cuánto ganas, ¿no? Igual, ¿no? A veces, sí, como dice Jennifer, obviamente cuando a usted le preguntan, ¿te gusta su trabajo? Sí. Ah, ¿y por qué trabaja ahí? Porque me encanta la gente, el ambiente, el jefe, o sea, that's, I mean, eso es lo que okay. Vamos a decir, I mean, but this is just for didactic purposes, yeah, solo para propósitos didácticos. These questions these questions can be done, or the this is a way to make questions. Remember, almost you always make a WH question. You always have first the W, and after you have do, and after the subject, and after the main verb maybe, and after the complement, okay? This is the structure. I don't know, question here, guys? Question here, guys? No?
No
questions. No questions. So then let's gonna answer this. Okay. Question number one. What is the word? How, where, who?
Where do you
where
live?
Where do you live? Exactly. Number two. Who, where, how? Oh my God. Hi, Claribel. La risa no le falla, Claribel.
Where, teacher?
Where does?
Where, dice Silvana. Ajá. Everybody agrees?
Yes. Where?
Yes. No, it's how.
No, teacher.
How does Michael?
How does Michael get to work? ¿Cómo llega Michael al trabajo? How does Michael get to work?
Michael.
He drives. Yeah, he drives to work. Number three.
How?
The question that ladies doesn't want to hear.
How?
Okay. How old are you? Okay. Number four. Uh-huh.
What is that?
If you don't know any question, you can ask me, teacher. Sorry, what's the meaning of? Okay. Number five.
Where?
Because it's place. Where is place? Where is my cell phone? ¿Dónde está mi celular?
Teacher,
hi.
The pronunciation where is about the sound is J, where or G, where?
Fíjese, vaya, le contesto. En realidad a nosotros nos cuesta, pero en realidad es where. Son aspiradas. Por eso son WH questions, porque son where. Where. Where is más. Permítame, voy a escribir acá en el chat. Veamos. Chat, I mean, where is the chat? I don't know. Dejo de compartir solo para escribir en el chat y luego me regreso. Veamos. Este es. Oh my. Este es where. Y este sería where. El primero es where. Y el segundo es where.
Where.
Exactly. Con Carlos estaba hablando, por ejemplo, creo, y le decía que era como la canción que hace años él dedicó cuando decía, why am I supposed to live without you? And you can listen to why. Why am I supposed to live without you? When you listen, why? That's why, where, what? Lo que pasa es que en realidad nadie dice what, porque le van a ver feo, no dice what, pero la pronunciación correcta es más what, o sea, es una J, y lo puede ver como, pero si oye, generalmente ya nos acostumbramos casi al what, okay? That's the point.
Okay.
Continue. Number six. Uh-huh.
Number six.
What? What?
When?
No.
What?
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 Do? What do cows? Sorry, cows eat.
Cows.
Okay. Yeah.
Teacher, how many Carmen. Cows?
Cows Carmen. Es Carmen.
Carmen.
Cows es vacas. Cows es vacas.
Cowboy.
Yeah, cowboy es vaquero. Cowboy.
Entonces,
ese es cow. Cows it.
¿Cuántas vacas comen?
¿Ah?
Ah, what?
¿Cuántas vacas comen? ¿Cómo?
¿Cómo cuántas vacas comen? ¿Qué comen las vacas? Boys. Very good.
Hierba.
Yes, they eat grass, hierba o pasto. Ajá.
Yes.
Who?
What?
Who?
No, who?
Who?
Okay. Who is your best friend?
Who
yeah.
is your best?
Exactly.
Who?
No es boyfriend ni girlfriend, es best friend, ¿ok? Aunque hoy la gente dice, mi primo is my best friend, es un conocido, y déjelo usted.
Some friends.
Joana tiene un término que no vamos a mencionar acá ahorita.
Un derecho.
Right, I mean, come on, guys, number eight. Uh-huh. When do you usually get up? Yeah, when? Because it's time.
I usually get up.
Exactly. When do you usually get up? Number nine, piece of cake.
What?
Number 10.
Do you stay home? If you finish it.
Where?
Who?
No.
No.
Why?
What?
Where do you
why?
Stay
home? Why?
¿Por qué está en la casa?
¿Por
qué te quedaste?
Why
did you stay home? I felt sick. Me sentía mal. Okay. Number 11.
What
is it? Number 12.
Who can?
Which?
When
can I start work? 13.
What?
Piece of cake. What time is it? 14. La pregunta que voy a hacer a las 8:04.
Why?
Why are you late? ¿Por qué estás tarde o por qué vienes tarde? 15.
Where
are your bags? They are over there. 16.
How
are you today? Excellent. I am fine, thanks. Okay, but remember, guys, these are the WH question, and sometimes they can be used with do or does. ¿Cuándo van a ser usadas with do and does? Cuando son preguntas directas. Cuando, por ejemplo, quiere preguntar. Si yo le preguntara, por ejemplo, a ustedes, ¿trabaja? Yo le digo, do you work? ¿Trabajas? Pero cuando yo le quiero preguntar, ¿dónde trabajas?
Where do you work?
Exacto. Y le pregunto, ¿por qué trabajas?
Why do you work?
Ya contestamos. La respuesta no me la deba. Ya contestamos. ¿Ok? Solo Jennifer trabaja for patient. ¿Ok? Ok. ¿Cómo trabajas, por ejemplo?
How
do you work? ¿Cómo trabajas? Do you work? Es como la base. Y volvemos. ¿Dónde trabajas?
Where do you work?
Exactly.
Where do you work?
¿Por qué trabajas?
Why do you work?
Exacto. ¿Cuál era la otra? ¿Cómo trabajas?
How do you work?
Exacto. That's the point. I don't know, guys, if you have understood the topic.
No, yes.
Oh, my God.
Yes, I understand.
Okay. Very good, guys. Okay. I don't know if you have any other question, I mean, about this, you can study, I mean, the WH questions, the structure, because I imagine and I remember, well, the one who were with me that I taught this topic, but I know that it's, I mean, it's very hard because we don't practice too much time and we don't have anybody to practice. Maybe that's why we forgot or we forget these topics, but you have to study, you have to practice. That's it. I don't know, question here?
No question.
No questions.
No questions, okay. So guys.
There is a word, teacher.
Huh?
There is a word. Come on. In that dialogue is
the dialogue. Is
trainer, teacher.
Trainer, entrenadora o capacitadora. Okay, I go for the attendance. Amilcar Cañengues Aceituno.
Present.
Very good. Alejandra Ostorga.
Present.
Okay, Ale, ya le explico y le mando esto, Ale. Very good. Carlos Bolaños.
Present.
Very good. Carlos Eduardo Rivas.
Present, teacher.
Daily Asensio.
Present.
Yanira Arevalo. No. Jennifer Mata.
Present.
Jorge Miranda.
Present.
José Nahum, no está. Margot Salinas tampoco. Emelina Iraeta de Salinas. Nahum Hernández Asensio. No. Nuria Vargas.
Present.
Oscar Esquivel.
Present.
Joana, the last one, Joana.
Present, teacher.
Saúl Adolfo Beltrán. Silvana Martínez.
Present, teacher.
Vanessa Guardado.
Present, teacher.
Yancy Erazo. Claribel Rosales.
Present, teacher.
Maritza Castellón.
I'm here, teacher.
Very good. Hugo Castro.
Present, teacher.
Very good. Guys, we have finished. Have a good weekend. If you are behind on the exercises, si se ha retrasado un poco los ejercicios, please do it. And see you on Monday.
See you on Monday.
Have a good night and have some drinks. Alejandra, Alejandra. Yo creo que Alejandra. Tiene que irse Alejandra al manual. Alejandra.
Okay, teacher.
Para to see the concepts there. Because okay. Maybe that's it. Okay.
Good night.
Bye, guys.
Bye. Good night, everybody.
Bye.
Bye.
Good night, everybody.
Bye. Everybody, see you. Do your exercises. Rest on the weekend. Or rest at weekend.
Yes.
Enjoy your family and do whatever you need to do.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Miss Mata. You have closed your mic. That's why I cannot hear you. No le oigo porque tiene apagado el micrófono.
No,
fine. No, don't worry. I know that you are stressful, and I appreciate your confidence. Okay, with the situation. De hecho, leí, siempre paso por los comentarios y le llamaron y vi el comentario que dejó la persona que, y vi la situación.
Oh, ya, ok. Muchas gracias. Sí, sí, estamos un poco estresados, sí, pero no hemos parado aquí, ¿no?
Sí, good. Questions, Ale? Questions, Jennifer, sorry, questions?
And my difficult is the pronunciation and my listening.
Okay, how can you improve that? ¿Cómo puedes mejorar eso? Solo oyendo.
Watch the movies.
Yeah, but maybe
listen to music.
Yes. That's it.
Okay. Tal vez vocabulario es el que me hace falta también, porque de repente yo puedo, tal vez, identifico como lo que usted está articulando, pero no estoy entendiendo porque no tengo ni cerebro.
I know. I mean, but what about that? I imagine, no sé cómo está your classmate, I mean, your coworker, the English teacher of the institution, maybe you can practice with him. It will be a good option. I mean, I don't know how are the relationship with him or with her.
I don't have time.
Yeah, and I know that. That is the time.
Conversation.
That is the main problem of the teacher, time. Yeah, yeah, I know. I'm a teacher. I mean, that's why I know what is
in
it.
In my free time, I have the
classes, great exams, great works, assign homeworks.
Responder.
Answer
the message in the cell phone.
Ah, your messages.
Está reventar my chat.
Yeah, my messages.
Okay.
Messages.
Maybe I difficult with the auxiliary.
Auxiliaries. Yeah. Yes, Jennifer. But what I mean, first, to improve your back, I mean, could be if you can read. I mean, if you can read, it will be a good way to improve your vocabulary. Read. To improve your listening and your pronunciation could be listening to music. I mean, when you start listening to music. Jennifer, are you there?
Okay. Yes, okay. Yes.
Because maybe you are freeze.
Okay. No, I'm here.
Okay. So you can listen into music. And for the grammar, maybe, I mean, you can help with some websites. I mean, the auxiliaries, you have to know that the auxiliaries is just the location inside the sentence. As by example, like the structure that we were studying today. When we say, as by example, where do is the auxiliary, you is the subject, and work is the main verb. Where do you work?
I would like read in English, but
I would like to.
I would like to read.
I would like to read in English. Yes. But you can start in, I don't know, I mean, I think that maybe as an educator in your institution, maybe you could have access to some material, even, I mean, you work for Colegio Adventista in San Salvador, yes? No.
In Cojutepeque.
Ah, in Cojutepeque. Oh my God. Do you live in Cojutepeque then? No.
Yeah.
Ah, okay. So, but I don't know if they have a library. Si tienen una librería.
Oh.
You can take some
only,
English.
Only read memes in English.
Okay, memes is just for fun. Okay, not to increase your vocabulary. To increase your vocabulary and to have a good English, you have to read good material. If you want to read memes, you are gonna have, I mean, different. But you can read, I mean, you can read books, or even you can start to read the Holy Bible in English.
Repeat, please. Even
you can read the Holy Bible in English.
Even is incluso.
Puede leer la Biblia en inglés.
Oh. Even
you can read. Bible. Aún también pueden leer. Ajá. Aún se puede leer the Holy Bible in English.
Ah. Okay. Yes. Yes. Yes.
Okay.
I need a Bible.
Ajá.
In
so,
English.
El punto es. Ajá, the point is, el punto es que a veces uno se aburre leyendo en inglés porque posiblemente la primera vez de 100 palabras va a entender una.
Exactly.
But if you start to read and read and look for each word, maybe you are gonna find, you are gonna have a good book. And also, Jennifer, you can download in your cell phone this app. I'm writing.
What
reference?
Diccionario.
Yeah. I think that is, as an app, is one of the best that I have found, because you are gonna find the real pronunciation, the phonetic symbols, you are gonna find all the applications, all the examples, synonym of the words. I mean, that is a complete dictionary, okay? So it will be good for you, maybe, because you can listen how do you pronounce. When I told you that I'm not pretty sure about the pronunciation of a word, is when I go to my Avanza Niños o Avanza Maestros también, and I go to this, to this app to watch, to see the pronunciation of the words.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Because in that way, I'm gonna find the real pronunciation. I'm gonna find the real words or another words in English, like synonyms. Mm-hmm.
Okay, thank
mm-hmm.
you for your tips.
Yeah, now we have YouTube. You can listen in YouTube, kind of music. I don't know what kind of music that you like, but I do reference to, to different songs because they have an easy English. Like when I saw, as for example, Carrie, por ejemplo, es una canción que yo recomendaría, digamos, porque tiene la pronunciación es bien sencilla. Cuando usted empieza, mm-hmm. When lights go down.
Billie Eilish.
¿Ah?
Billie Eilish.
You like Billie Eilish. Ah, yeah.
I try.
But Billie Eilish is a little, ajá, but el problema de la música actual, por ejemplo, es que es más, tiene menos ritmo y a veces tiene más, let me tell you the word. It has more contractions. La música de hoy tiene a veces hasta más contracciones. Mm. No sé si ya se dio cuenta cuando ve las letras que ve un montón de apóstrofes porque contraen demasiado las palabras.
Sí, es cierto.
Es diferente a la música oldie, la de los 70, 80 y 90. Como le digo, esta de Europa que se llama Carrie y empieza When lights go down, I see no reason. For you to cry. Entonces, no trae muchas deletion. Trae menos y es más fácil de entender de aprender, y cuando usted las entiende y las aprende, las puede pronunciar y le va a dar más este, eso, pronunciación.
Ok, perfecto.
Yeah.
Thank you.
So, nice. I like Ojute. I have gone many times. I like Ojute.
It's beautiful.
Yeah.
It's, all the Cojute is a supermarket. Todo Cojute un mercado.
Yeah, but I like. I mean, even the weather in the, in the mountain.
Yes.
The weather in the mountain.
Yes.
I like Cojute.
¿Cómo se dice nublado? Windy.
Ah, it's windy. Yeah.
It's windy.
Windy es como, más como, nublado es cloudy.
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 ¿Y windy?
Es windy como con viento.
Con ventoso.
O sea, con ventarrones.
Bueno, suena raro, pero...
con ventarrones, digamos, o sea, ese es el, no es el término ese, que es más como con ventarrones, cosas así.
Sí, porque con ventoso está raro.
Exactly. Cloudy es cuando dicen nublado, exactly. Cloudy.
Ajá, okay. That's it. Okay, teacher.
Okay, Jennifer. I hope your daddy get better.
Thank you. Ha sido buena su recuperación, solo que tenemos ya ahora sus 11 días que tiene, que está allá.
Bueno,
entonces,
pero
todos estos días
ha sido bastante estrés, me imagino, de la preocupación de cómo entonces, ha estado, cómo va a salir.
En casa mi mamá también se nos enfermó, entonces ella no está hospitalizada. Así que hemos estado ahí pendientes de todo.
Sí, me imagino.
So sorry, Jennifer.
I will pray for your family, okay? And
thank you.
I hope they get better, okay? Pero a usted no le dio al final, no le han dicho, ¿no?
Pues yo me saqué la prueba. Recién se lo llevaron a él y me salió negativa, pero de repente como síntomas raros, de repente como que muy irritada.
But you have the vaccine. Do you have the vaccine?
Yes.
Ah, okay.
Yes.
Okay.
But he doesn't.
He doesn't. Ahí usa el auxiliar. He does not. He doesn't.
He doesn't.
Ahí se usa el auxiliar. Más que todo para preguntas y respuestas cortas. Y lo mismo aquí que usted dice, he does not, él no, he doesn't.
Perfect, thank you.
You're welcome. Okay, then, okay. Jennifer, and have a good night. I mean, I hope, as I told you, that your family get better, and see you on Monday, okay? Be careful.
Thank you. Good night, teacher. Blessing for you.
Thank you. Blessing for your family.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Bye.